So let's talk about this ARP. ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. And this ARP protocol works in the data link layer and also network layer. And it resolves IP address to its MAC address. Because why we need to resolve this IP address to MAC address means MAC address is required to communicate in a local area network. If you have switched network, then you absolutely need the MAC address. And MAC address is must and should in order to receive and transfer the data. This IP to MAC address mapping is stored in ARP cache, and broadcast MAC contains RFs. So the router gets the data and it identifies your computer and gives to you. If you want to communicate to other computer, you need to get the MAC address of that computer. Otherwise, you cannot send the data. For that, if you know the IP address, and you can easily ask every other computer who has this IP address, tell me your MAC address. By that way, you can get the MAC address. And broadcast MAC contains RFs. Okay. You need to remember this point. It will be useful in the next slide. So this is how this ARP takes place. I have the four computers, PC 1, 2, 3, 4, and a switch, and this IP address is 10.1.1.2, 10.2.2.2, and I want to connect to the PC4, and I know only the IP address of the PC4, and it is 10.1.1.1. And what I does is I send a packet with this message: who has 10.1.1.1, tell your MAC to me in the sense this IP address, because they cannot understand me, but they can understand this IP address. And what I do is I put the MAC address, my MAC address, as FFFFFFFF, so all 12 bytes to F, and it indicates that the switch, upon seeing this RFs, if it broadcasts to every other computer except the port originating from it. So since my MAC address have the FFFFs, then the switch distributes broadcast this message to every other computer in the network. So this message will be received by PC 2, 4, and 3. So upon PC receiving by the PC 3, PC 3 inspects this message: who has 10.1.1.1. since this computer's IP address is not 10.1.1.1, it will simply discards this message right there, and PC2 also discards this message, but PC4 replies to this message because it has 10.1.1.1, and it tells its MAC address to 10.2.2.2, which is PC1. So it replies with a message telling its MAC address, and this switch will sends the response to the PC1. So thus PC1 knows the MAC address of PC4, and from there onwards PC1 can send the data to the PC4. So generally what attackers does is a local copy of this all MAC addresses to the IP address mapping are stored in the switch, and what these hackers do is they will just modify this IP address to MAC address mapping to their computer IP address and this victim's MAC address. So whenever any computer wants to send the data to this computer, hackers receive that message, and they will modify, or they can do somewhat damage. So we'll see the ARP spoofing in network pen testing. So we can check our local ARP cache also. Our computer contains also a local copy of ARP cache, and in Windows system you can access using ARP-A. So you can see these are the interfaces I have, and okay, this is my main Wi-Fi interface. You can see 192.168.0.103. And here you can see this is my routers, and the router MAC address is this one, and this is the another, I think it's phone, and I have this MAC address, and you can see the type is dynamic. dynamic in the sense you need to send this message to everyone, and that message will be inspected by the destination and response will be received by us. By sending this message and updating automatically is called dynamic. And if you enter manually your IP address and the MAC address, then it is called static. But I don't know how this came, but I did not enter these entries, and these entries are dynamic.